Hi, I am Valder Beebe. I am the host and the visionary of That Celebrity Interview.
I want my audience to know that I get to talk with investigative journalist Diane Diamond. She's on Investigation Discovery, and you know it's the number one true crime network. And you're here to talk about 9 at 9, and if they missed Memorial Day, what can we catch them up? What did they miss?
Well, last night we started this promotion, 9 at 9, 9 all-new, brand-new crime stories that I know everyone tunes in to see at 9 o'clock Eastern Time. Last night we started the promotion. We did a special on the Jeffrey Dahmer case. And coming up, we have lots of other ones. Brittany Murphy, who killed Jeffrey Epstein, an in-depth look at the Jennifer Dulos case, a mother of five out of Connecticut. Her body still has not been recovered. And on and on. We've got 9 brand new shows for you.
Okay, let's do a little bit on Brittany Murphy and Jeffrey Epstein.
All righty.
Brittany's death is it still suspicious? Can you start there?
Yeah, sure. There are some that firmly believe that she did not die of natural causes, anemia and pneumonia, as the medical examiner said. After her death, her estranged father surfaced and said, "Wait a minute. I don't believe that she was died of natural causes. She was just 32 years old." So he got a second autopsy done. And he reports that they found 10 heavy metals in her body. Now, whoa, wait a minute. Where did that come from? Was she poisoned and not just anemic and died of pneumonia? He further says that he believes it was Brittany's mother who may have poisoned her. And this is why he says that. Brittany had married a man named Simon Monjack. He was a UK citizen. Many people described him as a con man. And she died. And then 5 months later, Simon Monjack died of exactly the same thing, anemia and pneumonia. Well, this was a 300-pound man. How did he have anemia? So Brittany's father really firmly believes that somebody poisoned both of them with these heavy metals. And frankly, he points the finger. You'll hear him on the special. He points the finger at Brittany's mother, who was living with them.
Does the film show the mother recanting, saying that, that's not true or anything like that, or just she doesn't get a voice?
Oh, no, she gets a voice, absolutely. You will see her with Simon Monjack in that period after Brittany died, before he died. And they the minute she died, they started a foundation. They started a PR blitz to keep her memory alive, her positive memory alive. And yes, you will see Sharon on the program itself. I should further say that Brittany's estranged father, believed that Simon and Brittany were making plans to move to New York, and that Mama was not going to be invited along to move. And so this is maybe why she took this move. And it is speculation at this point, and we are clear to say that. But Sharon, you will absolutely see Sharon in the special.
This is riveting. I haven't even seen it, and I want to see it. This is what my audience, I put out something last week that you would be on the show, and they wanted to know the most about this one. The next one, if we could talk just a little bit about it, is Jeffrey Epstein, which has questions for everybody, even if people who don't even know who he is, people have questions.
Yeah. He really is a quintessential American success story. He sort of came from modest means and became a billionaire. His friends were princes and presidents and leaders in tech and academia. He really knew how to network, this guy. But what he's most remembered for, I think, two things. Sexually assaulting bevies of young girls. I mean, girls as young as 13 years old. And did he commit suicide or not? That's the name of our special, Who Killed Jeffrey Epstein? We present scenarios on that, and then you, the viewer, can decide. Did he commit suicide, or did someone come into his cell and help that process along and then make it look like suicide? What do you think?
It's very confusing. I have no idea. I was shocked, just like the nation was when they found him in his cell. It's just something you just don't know unless somebody comes across and confesses or the police really find someone. I want my audience to know that Diane Diamond, she's one of the few journalists who have mastered the art of her craft across several platforms. She does radio, television, books, internet publishing, and you know she's a quintessential journal on investigation discovery. Mm-hmm. Diane, did you think you would be continuing your career in the way that maybe you had planned it?
Oh, boy, that's such a good question. You know, I started as a radio reporter in Albuquerque, New Mexico. And I then went to Washington, D.C. and worked for NPR. I was a newscaster there and covered politics in Washington for many years. And then I discovered the world of crime and justice, and it just attracted me so strongly that it's been my career ever since. I used to be on the television show Hard Copy. I've written three books, one about Michael Jackson, another one about the White House gate crashers. You remember that couple,
I remember
the Salahis?
Those people.
Yeah. And I write a weekly syndicated column, which was made into a compilation book about crime and justice issues that fascinate me. I hope they fascinate you, too.
Not necessarily fascinate. You're going to have a job forever because it doesn't seem like people are getting any better. I mean, really, there's so many crimes that need to be dissected for ordinary people.
You know, my latest column was on the Arbery shooting in North Carolina, the father and son duo, the citizen's arrest that went wrong, and this handsome young man, 25 years old, winds up dead in the street simply because he was jogging in the neighborhood. So that's one that I'm watching. I hope that comes to trial. I hope that doesn't plead out, and we never get to really hear the truth about that.
Were you as surprised as we were when they... cameraman with murder, the guy who took the picture and also made him a murder suspect?
Yeah, there's now been three arrests there, the father-son duo, the McMichaels, and this man who took that infamous video that we've all seen. I was not surprised, because if you're that close and you're watching what happens and you're bothering to stop and film it instead of calling the police, that's very suspicious to me. So, you know, look, if you're involved in a conspiracy, as we always tell you on Investigation Discovery, if you are even a peripheral player in a conspiracy, you are guilty of the underlying crime. And so that man is in big trouble.
It sounds like my husband, an ex-state police officer. Diane, you are fascinating, and I know you from Hard Copy. That's where I first had my interaction with you, so I will follow you anywhere you go. When do you want us to watch you on Investigation Discovery?
Well, this special, 9 at 9, goes on until June 2nd. We've got all sorts of different cases coming up. The Jennifer Dulos case out of Connecticut. The Tiger King will be the last one that we do. The man who brought Tiger King to the public, you'll hear his story for the first time.
I don't know what the fascination is with him. Yeah, I don't know what the fascination is
both.
With the Tiger King. Diane Diamond, you are a treasure.
You.
Thank you so much for being my guest on the Valder BB Show. We will be watching.
Thanks, Valder. Stay safe.
Hi, I'm Valder BB. I host the Valder BB Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com. Hi, I'm Valder Beebe, host of the Valder Beebe Show. I have used Credit Help USA, the credit restoration company that's bonded and state certified. When you become a client of Credit Help USA, you become eligible for a set of stainless steel cookware from Credit Help USA and the Valder Beebe Show. Get your credit straight today. Visit CreditHelpTX.com, click on the Valder BB Show icon, and get started living life divinely.